I ain't asking for much, just a few septums.
As if Skyrim didn't have enough outsiders. Now we've got mercenaries from Hammerfell strutting about.
Gonna get it, Sissel.
Why? What did I do? I told you to weed the garden by sunset, and you didn't do it. Now you're in big trouble. Papa told you to do that, not me. Now leave me alone.
I wish I could be an adventurer like you.
If you beat up my sister,
go wherever I want.
I won't tell.
Thank you. favor the ball, eh? I'm a sword man.
This is Markarth, traveler. Safest city in the Reach.
A bit of jewelry for your journey home?
Oh, this pendant would look lovely on my sister.
The Reach belongs to the Forsworn!
Hey!
Guards! Forsworn!
I'd die for my people.
The Markarth city.
The Arno Forsworn here.
The Forsworn. You're inside the city.
I used to be an adventurer like you, and I took an arrow in the knee.
Come on in. The Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink and clean rooms.
Unlike my husband Clapper, I watch after our guests.
What was that you said, venomous wife of mine?
Why are you looking at me like that? The Dark Brotherhood. Oh, I... My goodness, you're really here. The Black Sacrament. It actually worked? What I need is for Alain Dufont to die. I want him hunted down and murdered like the dog he is. I didn't know it when we were... with each other, but Elaine is actually the leader of a band of cutthroats. Bandits. They're holed up in some old dwarven ruin. Raldbathar. It's near Windhelm. They use it as their base. It's where they stage their raids. I want you to go to that ruin, find Elaine Dufont, and kill him. I don't care about his friends. Do whatever you want with them. But Elaine has to die. Excellent. Once Elaine is dead, I'll pay you. In gold. I've saved up a bit. I hope that'll do. But, well, there is one more thing, if you're interested. If you can, I want you to kill someone else as well. You don't have to, not as part of our deal, but if you do, I'll pay you even more. It's Nilsine Shattershield in Windhelm. If Nilsine dies too, I'll make it worth your while. I went to Windhelm to see the Shatter Shields. They were old and dear friends, and in mourning. Frigga was killed recently. Murdered. I met Elaine in the tavern, while I was drinking my sadness away. He was handsome and charming. He said I was the beautiful lily of his dreams. Elaine made all the pain just go away. But it was all lies. Elaine used me. He ruined my name, destroyed my friendship with the Shatter Shields. Do you know why Elaine was in Windhelm? He heard about Frigga's murder. He wanted to befriend the family, in their grief, and rob them blind. Elaine used me to get close to my friends. And now they all think I'm some kind of monster. Elaine Dufont took my life, and now I'm taking his. Don't you see? I was like a daughter to Tova, a sister to Nelsine and Frigga. But the family refuses to believe my innocence, no matter what I say. Couldn't they understand that I was used? That I was grieving for Frigga too? No, they treated me like garbage, threw me away. With Nelsine dead, maybe then Tova will realize what she's lost, huh? Maybe then she'll see that I was just as much a daughter as the others. And if not, may she drown in her own tears. I planned to kill Elaine myself, you know. Nilsine too, but lost my nerve. I even brewed a special poison, lotus extract. Maybe you could use it? Just coat your weapon with it, then you get the idea. Make them all pay for what they've done to me. Isn't there some business you should be tending to?
This is a surprise.
Come on. count out your coins.
These dwarves were prodigious.
Thank you.
Ain't asking for much. Just a few septums. What do you... Enough!
Come on in. The Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink and clean rooms.
Unlike my husband Clapper, I watch after our guests.
Well, what news? Is Elaine? Thank you. That bastard got exactly what he deserved. And I heard about Nilsine. You have more than fulfilled your part of the bargain. Please, take this. As payment, and a symbol of my affection. I'll never forget you. Hello again.
I'm what you'd call a soldier of fortune. Make me an offer, and I just can't find...
What am I supposed to do? Never leave the house? You want that?
You're back. So, how went your first real contract? A bit more exciting than what Nazir's been offering, I'd wager? Very well. I respect your discretion. Now, I need your assistance with a matter of a more... personal nature. It's Cicero. Ever since he arrived, his behavior's been... well, erratic would be an understatement. I do believe he is truly mad, but it's worse than that. He's taken to locking himself in the Nightmother's chamber and talking to someone in hushed but frantic tones. Who is he speaking with? What are they planning? I fear treachery. You must understand. If Cicero is turning the others against me, against us, our family would not survive such division. Dear brother, I need you to steal into that chamber and eavesdrop on their meeting. It'll be no use clinging to the shadows. They'll see you for sure. No, you need a hiding place. Somewhere they'd never think to look. Like... inside the Nightmother's coffin. No objections then? Good. Go now, before they meet, and report back to me with whatever you learn. That's the real question, isn't it? The jester enters, seals the door, and the conversation begins. So someone must be waiting for him inside. Any one of us could enter that chamber silently, unnoticed. But who amongst us would dare conspire against the sanctuary? The very thought breaks my heart. I don't believe so. But I'll be able to instruct you further after you've returned from the chamber. It depends on what you learn. And make haste. You must be in place before Cicero and his... ally arrive. They could be planning another meeting any time. Isn't it obvious? As the Night Mother's keeper, he believes he's entitled to rule of this sanctuary. Cicero will cite our independence as the need to revert to the old ways. He'll claim we're undisciplined, unruly, heretical even. Ironically, the Night Mother could prove to be just as much a victim, the queen in a fool's twisted game of chess. Go, quickly. Hide in the coffin before Cicero and the traitor meet.
Are we alone?
Yes.
Yes! Alone! Sweet solitude! No one will hear us, disturb us. Everything is going according to plan. The others, I've spoken to them, and they're coming around, I know it. The wizard Festus Crex. Perhaps even the Argonian and the Unchild. What about you? Have you spoken to anyone? No? No, of course not. I do the talking, the stalking, the seeing, and the saying. And what do you do? Nothing! Not that I'm angry. Oh, never. Cicero understands. Cicero always understands. And obeys. You will talk when you're ready, won't you? Won't you? Sweet Night Mother.
Poor Cicero. Dear Cicero. Such a humble servant. But he will never hear my voice, for he is not the listener.
Oh, but how can I defend you? How can I exert your will if you will not speak to anyone?
Oh, but I will speak. I will speak to you, for you are the one. You who shares my iron tomb, who warms my ancient bones, I give you this task. Journey to Wallen Road. Speak with Armand Moutier.
Poor Cicero has failed you. Poor Cicero is sorry, sweet mother. I've tried so very hard, but I just can't find the listener.
Tell Cicero the time has come. Tell him the words he has been waiting for all these years. Darkness rises when silence dies.
What? What treachery? Defiler! Debaser and defiler! You have violated the sanctity of the Night Mother's coffin! Explain yourself! Speak, worm! She spoke to you? More treachery! More trickery and deceit! You lie!
The Night Mother speaks only to the listener! And there is no listener! She said that. She said those words. To you. Darkness rises when silence dies. But those are the words. The binding words. Written in the keeping tomes. The signal so I would know. Mother's only way of talking to sweet Cicero. And it's true. She's back. Our Lady is back. She has chosen a listener. She has chosen you. All hail the listener.
By Sithis, this ends now. Back away, fool. Whatever you've been planning is over.
Are you all right? I heard the commotion. Who was Cicero talking to? Where's the accomplice?
Reveal yourself, traitor.
I spoke only to the Night Mother. I spoke to the Night Mother, but she didn't speak to me. Oh, no! She spoke only to him, to the listener.
What? The listener? What are you going on about? What is this lunacy?
It's true! It's true! The Night Mother has spoken! The silence has been broken! The listener has been chosen!
When I heard Cicero screaming, I knew you'd been discovered. I feared the worst. Are you all right? You look like you've just seen a ghost. Please tell me you haven't. Cicero said he spoke to the Night Mother, but she spoke to you. What? So Cicero wasn't talking to anyone else. Just the Night Mother's body? And the Night Mother, who, according to everything we know, will only speak to the person chosen as listener, just spoke. Right now. To you? By Sithis. And? What did she say? Amand Motier? I have no idea who that is. But Valenrud, that I have heard of. And I know where it is. No. No! Listen, I don't know what's going on here, but you take your orders from me. Are we clear on that? The Night Mother may have spoken to you. But I am still the leader of this family. I will not have my authority so easily dismissed. I need time to think about all this. Go see Nazir. Do some work for him. I'll find you when I'm ready to discuss the matter further.
You are the listener! I have served Mother well, I have! You are the listener! You are the listener! I have served Mother well, I have! The listener, well, listens. The Night Mother speaks to you, guides you on your path. But when the Night Mother speaks, the listener must obey. You must, for her word is the will of Sithis, and Sithis is the Dark Brotherhood incarnate. Oh, well, yes, I did indeed. I tried to listen, tried so hard, but the Night Mother never spoke to poor Cicero. The silence became almost maddening. Oh, but that was then, this is now. You're the listener, and the Night Mother chose you for a reason, I'm sure. Cicero will remain the happy keeper.
Surely you're pulling Cicero's leg! Wait! The listener is serious.
Oh.
Well, of course the Night Mother will speak to you again. She might speak now, or later, or... I don't know. But speak she will. The Night Mother is part of you now. You get to hear voices inside your head. The rest of us should be so lucky. Are you excited? Oh, you should be. Things are finally looking up.